After repair, your micro brass motor and solder a new motor wires to it, doing a full disassembly of the micro brass motor to get your mini drone back flying again. And let's dig into it. And all the things you need is actually only a crooked Stanley knife. And a really sharp one. To get it disassembled, we have to remove the cap. And that is the most difficult thing to get away. The motors are completely okay. They are pretty strong motors, 6mm and spinning completely free. But they are missing the motor wires. And I like to use them because they are giving me 40 grams of thrust, all four of them. So that's 10 grams of thrust by each motor. That's pretty awesome for a 6mm motor, brass micro motor. And let's show you how to disassemble it. Not gonna be easy. But there are four points where the cap is like holding by the outer casing. That we have to destroy, remove a little bit. I'm just gonna poke inside of it and try to push it out on all four sides. And if that doesn't work, then I will get a tiny pin and try to get in there and just wiggle it open. And when you have wiggled it open enough, then you could use your Stanley knife to get in between the outer casing and the top cap and just get in between there and try to pull it up. Because it's curved, you're like using a lot of that curve, so you get almost like one third around the cap, giving you a lot more bite.
I'm going around, 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 and slowly it's coming out. You just have to keep on poking the four holes and slowly the cap will release and the inner spooling will come out. This is a close-up of the cap with the two brushes that have to touch the axle of the inner spooling when we are assembling everything again. So it's pretty important to put the axle straight in between those two brushes. You see those two lines? Those are the brushes at the end. And the axle has to fit in between when we assemble everything. So this is very important. A copper spooling is completely solid. There are no extra pieces or parts on it. It's just copper spooling. And then glued in with 2-coupon glue. And all attached together on the top and probably also on the inside. And the outer case is just a metal case with a magnet on the inside. It shows up really difficult, but there you can really see the magnet on the inside. But we first are going to solder the wires back into place before we are going to assemble everything again. So let's get on with it. It's a shame that I got 3 red wires and 1 black wire, and they are super thin wires. They are not every wire that will fit through those holes, but you have to push the wire through the hole and solder it on the other side to the brush, to the brushes. It's just a question of putting the motor back, assembling it back in its place, and I want to say that the axle on the top is thinner than the axle at the bottom. It's almost twice the size as this axle. So there's no way that you can place it wrong. You just have to put it back into the hole. So it surrounds the magnet on the inside. And now it's just a question of the most fiddly job is getting that axle in between the two brushes. And it shows up really bad on camera, so we're gonna try our best. Some little bit of glue, 2-coupon glue, to make sure the cap is back in its place and stays in its place, so we can supply it with power and test how good it works.
We have assembled a bag into the aircraft and now we're gonna show you it works. Now I've shown you how to disassemble your micro brush motors, how to solder new wires to the brushes, how to assemble it, making it work just like it did straight out of the box. I hope you like this video, then give it a thumbs up, and if you didn't, then give it a thumbs down. Subscribe for my weekly videos that are coming out, and I want to wish you a happy flying and goodbye until next time.